Vaping and the use of e-cigarettes are often marketed as a safer alternative to traditional cigarette smoking. But this product has been on the market for over 20 years. And is that really true? And especially, what does vaping and use of e-cigarettes do to your fertility? If you are trying to conceive, if you are struggling from infertility and curious about how vaping, either yourself or with a close partner and in proximity, has to do with your own fertility, this information is for you. Let's get started. I'm Dr. Laura Shaheen. I'm a double board certified OBGYN and reproductive endocrinologist, helping people build families for over 20 years. And a lot of the counseling I do is with lifestyle optimization, things that are great for your fertility, like focusing on nutrition, stress management, sleep, moving your body, and some habits that are not helpful for your fertility, like increase exposure to endocrine disruptors, excessive alcohol, excessive marijuana, and smoking. And vaping often comes up. I really want people to understand what the evidence says about vaping and fertility and make sure that it is really clear about what is right for you. I love educating, and there's two other ways to make sure that you stay in contact and you get more information. Number one is signing up for my newsletter. It's a weekly newsletter with lots of information, educational content, and products I recommend. And my other way is my weekly podcast with interviews and in-depth discussions, Baby Your Best Fertility Podcast. You can find it on a playlist on my YouTube channel and anywhere you listen to podcasts. But today we are focusing on vaping and its impact on your fertility. We're going to go over some main topics. Topic number one, how does vaping impact female fertility? Topic number two, how does vaping impact male fertility? Topic number three, if it's harmful, why exactly is it harmful? We'll break down the components. And stick around to the end of the video because I give practical and helpful tips on quitting. Created by Hong Lik, a Chinese pharmacist and inventor, the e-cigarette was designed as an alternative for traditional cigarette smoking. The first e-cigarette came to market in 2003. E-cigarettes have dramatically evolved over the last 20 plus years, but in general, they consist of these main components. A cartridge with fluid, a heat source like a battery, an atomizer to vaporize the liquid with that heat to turn it into a vapor for you to inhale. As recently as 2023, there were over 500 brands of e-cigarettes and 8,000 flavors available on the market. The popularity of vaping and using e-cigarettes has really exploded over the last few years. As recently as 2018, 85% of people aged 18 to 29 had tried vaping at least once. Often marketed as a safer option to traditional cigarettes, which are known to cause significant health hazards, vaping really has become very popular. But what does it do to your fertility? Short answer, it's not good. I'm going to be referring a lot to an excellent study that came out in 2023 that was a full review of the impact of traditional cigarette smoking and vaping or use of e-cigarettes and its impact on reproduction. This study came out in a journal called Life, published in 2023, and the lead author was Debbie Montjean. And she and her team combined a lot of evidence to be able to say exactly how nicotine, certain components of the flavoring, and a lot of the chemicals that are used in vaping can impact reproduction on multiple levels. I'll make sure that you have the reference to this article. It's a free article and you can read it. It's got hundreds of references, a lot of information. I'm going to be summarizing it for you here. Topic number one, vaping and its impact on female fertility. In summary, vaping, use of e-cigarettes is horrible for female reproduction. There's three main ways that we know that these chemicals like nicotine and some of the chemicals that you can inhale with a vapor like heavy metals, formaldehyde, can impact female fertility. Number one, egg quality. So a lot of the chemicals you can inhale with vaping result in oxidative stress in every cell in our body. Oxidative stress really impacts the ability of a cell to replicate DNA. And that is what eggs are doing every time that you ovulate and you're trying to fertilize with a sperm to help you conceive and get pregnant. And so the chemicals that you're inhaling with vaping are impacting egg quality at a cellular level. Number two, vaping impacts hormones. It has an incredible imbalance of estrogen, testosterone, the function of hormones. It's all of the mix of chemicals that you are inhaling that can dramatically change how your hormonal system is working. Studies have shown that traditional cigarette smoking as well as vaping can result in irregular ovulation, irregular menstrual cycles, and really throw off the ability and the time to conception if you're trying to conceive. The third way that vaping can impact female fertility is effective implantation of an embryo into the uterine cavity. Nicotine, which is one of the biggest chemicals that it's in vaping, is a vasoconstrictor, and it can impact the ability of your uterus to build up a thick lining ready for an embryo to implant. Blood supply to the ovaries to help them try to ovulate, blood supply to the uterus to support an early pregnancy. Traditional cigarette smoking and vaping have been associated with a decreased risk of implantation, increased risk of miscarriage, and overall affecting your ability to get pregnant. Even if you're not planning to get pregnant right now, vaping could impact your egg quality and function for years to come. So if you really are thinking about your reproduction in the future, even if it's not right now, this is something that's really important to consider quitting. Topic number two, vaping and male reproduction. Short answer, it's not good. Sperm are a lot easier to study outside of the body than eggs, which are inside the ovaries within the body. And traditional cigarette smoking, as well as studies on the components of vaping, like nicotine, formaldehyde, a lot of the heavy metals, have shown that increased exposure to these chemicals can associate it with poor sperm production, poor sperm motility, and again, this increase in oxidative stress at a cellular level that can impact the DNA integrity of sperm and its function. So these chemicals are affecting on a cellular level, increasing oxidative stress. Cells do not work as well. And higher levels of DNA fragmentation in sperm in men that are smoking or are being exposed to these chemicals, lower sperm counts, longer time to conception. It's all there. It's all been studied and really important to understand. Another important thing to think about is nicotine can impact sexual function. Nicotine is a vasoconstrictor, and it can be associated with sexual dysfunction and erectile dysfunction. Vaping has also been associated with disruptive hormone levels and decreased testosterone in men. So on many different levels, nicotine and a lot of the chemicals that you're exposing yourself to with vaping can result in poor sperm production and function, changes in hormone levels like testosterone, and decreased sexual function in men. Topic number three, why is vaping so harmful? Like, let's break it down a little bit to the components so you really understand more. Number one, nicotine. That is one of the most harmful chemicals you can find in both traditional cigarette smoking as well as vaping. It's highly addictive. It's a vasoconstrictor, like we've talked about. So it decreases blood flow to all the organs, including your reproductive organs, and can result in sexual dysfunction. Nicotine is directly toxic to reproductive cells like eggs. Other chemicals to think about in vaping products, especially, you know, these e-cigarettes, are propylene glycol and glycerin. These can have direct toxic effects on cells. These are some of the chemicals that really increase oxidative stress and impact the function of eggs and sperm. Number three, heavy metals. So heating up the metals of an e-cigarette allows us to inhale with the vapors many different heavy metals like lead, cadmium, and nickel, which have all been found to be toxic to our reproductive health. Finally, the fourth component of e-cigarettes that can be extremely toxic to our reproductive health is formaldehyde and other VOCs, or volatile organic compounds, that are found in the flavoring components of these vaping products. They make it taste good, but it can be addictive. But these flavoring components with the volatile organic compounds, or the VOCs, can be directly toxic to all of our cells, and especially our vulnerable reproductive cells. So I know this is overwhelming, especially if you have been, you know, marketed to and made to think that vaping is safer than traditional cigarette smoking. Neither of them are safe, especially for your reproductive health. And so the best thing that you can do is to quit smoking, to quit vaping, if you really want to focus on your reproductive health now and in the future. And I want to leave you with some tips for quitting. I also just want to say for a second, I know I've come on pretty strong with the evidence here. I really want you to look at that paper that I've referenced here if you want like the actual evidence in, you know, mice and in humans and all of the direct evidence. If you need that proof, it is all there. But I also just really want to recognize how addictive these products can be. And I don't want you to carry around shame if you're really struggling with quitting. I'm from Winston-Salem, North Carolina. My family was in the tobacco business, even going back to my grandmother growing up on a tobacco farm in Kentucky. I've been surrounded by smoking and people addicted to cigarettes and vaping, you know, a lot of my life. And I can very much appreciate the power of that addiction. And so I can empathize with the fact that it can be very difficult. You can want to quit, but it can be really, really hard. And so I really think that this information is important. I think it's important to get out there, but I just also want to say, like, if you're struggling with trying to quit, you are not alone. And I do want to share some tips, but I'm not saying that it's easy. And I just really want you to find the support that you need. So let me share some tips that might be helpful for you if you're trying to quit. I can think of five. Number one, set a quit date. Especially if you and your partner vape or smoke together, it's a part of your relationship or things like that, together, decide on a quit date. And if your partner is not ready to do that, that's okay. You can do it yourself. But it might be easier if you decide that this is something that you want to do together. But you yourself, if you're doing it, set a quit date. It can be very helpful to kind of have that on the calendar, commit to that, and kind of have a countdown to it. Number two, seek support. Listen, any sort of addiction is hard to stop alone. There are support groups. You can have friends that might have quit in the past and been successful and kind of give you that support that you need. Hopefully your partner is going to be supportive if you have one. But that second tip, find support. Number two, replace the habit. So sometimes it's not even the nicotine that you're addicted to or even the flavor. It's just the mechanical process of lighting up, inhaling, you know, kind of that process. And so finding an alternative to that process can help break the habit. Finding something else that you can focus on, maybe exercise, maybe journaling, maybe a new hobby, maybe I remember this, this really old TV show with a detective named Kojak. He was always sucking lollipops, and the reason he was doing that was because he was trying to quit smoking. And so, I mean, sugar, you know, health of your teeth, all that kind of stuff. Maybe lollipops isn't right for you, but I remember that very distinctly. My dad watching Kojak on the TV when I was young, and he was always with a lollipop. But finding something to sort of substitute that habit. And so maybe the hardest part for you is like maybe you wake up every morning and you reach for that e-cigarette or that vaping product. If you don't have it within reach and you have something else within reach that you could do, whether it's a meditation, whether it's journaling, whether it is doing like, you know, 10 sit-ups as soon as you get up or a little bit of a stretching routine, substituting that habit with something else can be helpful. Maybe you vape after a meal. And so trying to find something to substitute for that, whether it's ending your meal with tea or ending your meal with like a 10-minute walk around the block, just finding something to substitute for that habit can be helpful. Tip number four, nicotine replacement therapy. If you really are addicted to the component of nicotine in the vaping or the e-cigarettes, you can get nicotine gum, you can get patches. That's not a long-term fix because nicotine in and of itself is harmful for reproduction, but helping to break the habit, it can be a temporary thing to lean on until you can also quit the nicotine patch or gum or replacement. Number five, focus on your why. And you might have to come up with a mantra of why you're quitting. something that you could write in a journal every single day. Just don't forget the purpose. The purpose is to improve your overall health. And if your number one goal right now is to start your family, add to your family, to get pregnant and have a baby, that is your why. That might be your why. Just remember it and help remind yourself of why you're trying to quit. Let's recap those five tips. Number one, set a quit date. Number two, seek support. Number three, replace the habit with a new habit. Number four, temporary nicotine replacement therapy. And number five, focus on your why. So no question that vaping and the use of e-cigarettes is harmful for reproduction, whether you've got eggs or sperm. And if your goal is to get pregnant now or in the future, quitting vaping can be one of the most important things that you can do. I hope you found this video helpful. Like this video if you found it helpful. Be sure and comment with any questions that you have and subscribe to this channel so you don't miss my weekly videos all about reproductive health. Until next week, wishing you love, luck, and pineapples.